Thank you for joining us today, and Minister Freeland, I want to thank you, and Ambassador McNaughton, thank you very much. We had a great discussion regarding the trade negotiations between Canada and the United States. We had a productive and frank meeting. They provided me with an update on the progress we're making, and I reaffirmed Ontario's government standing shoulder to shoulder with our federal counterparts. I also shared the concerns of our steel, aluminum, and automotive industry, their concerns when we met yesterday. My friends, we must stand together during these critical negotiations because there's so much at stake. Jobs across our economy, workers and their families, entire communities, are all counting on us to defend Ontario's interests and Canada's interest. And we will do just that. We will stand united as a nation because we're all in this together. Ontario will not sit on the sidelines. We will defend Ontario jobs. And as I've said, Ontario is open for business. We're open to trade and investment. We'll create business-friendly environment. We'll lower taxes, lower hydro rates, cut red tape and regulation. We'll do our part to create jobs to make Ontario more competitive. We're going to work hard to keep our economic ties with the U.S. strong because the relationship between Canada and the United States is the greatest economic relationship in the entire world. Our province is already, just think of these numbers, out of 19 states, we're the largest trading partner. We're number 2 to 9 other states. And these numbers are staggering. We trade $390 billion. Ontario alone does trade of $390 billion a year in 2017. That's roughly about 55% of overall trade that we do with the United States. And we want to expand this even further. I'm ready to take our case to the American political and business people down there and voice our opinion, work closely, again, with our federal counterparts. And it was a real privilege, again, speaking to the minister and the ambassador. We're going to be working hand in hand to make sure that we negotiate this trade deal and make sure we're successful at that. I believe by working together, we can get a great deal on both sides that we can be proud of. Because everyone benefits when a deal gets struck here. The U.S. wins, Canada wins, and Ontario wins. And we look forward to that. And again, Minister, I want to thank you. It's a pleasure. Ambassador, it was a real pleasure. And I want to reaffirm that we will stand shoulder to shoulder with our federal counterparts to make sure that we have an acceptable trade deal with our neighbors and our friends. I emphasize our friends south of the border.
Thank you very much, Premier-designate Doug Ford. We had a very good conversation, a long, substantive conversation, and I said to the Premier-designate how much I appreciate the strong position he has taken, as you have just heard, expressing a shoulder-to-shoulder solidarity with the federal government. And I would really like to thank him for that. And I would like to thank all of Canada's premiers. This is a very important negotiation for Canada. The Canada-U.S. economic relationship is an important relationship. And one of the things which has been so valuable to Canada as we have gone into these conversations is the fact that Canada is playing as a totally united team. That is absolutely essential. That is a powerful message for all Canadians, and it's a powerful message for Americans. And in fact, I was very glad I was in Washington this morning with Ambassador McNaughton. And I met this morning with Ambassador Lighthizer, the USTR, to continue our NAFTA conversations. And he asked me about the election in Ontario And I was really glad to be able to say to him that I was coming back to Toronto this afternoon. I would be meeting with the Premier designate, and that we have, and I'm confident will continue to have, a very strong united position.
Thank you.
Just one at a time here. Mike, step up.
Lauren Pelley, CBC News. Mr. Ford, there's growing concern in Toronto about what a change in government could mean for the support for harm reduction efforts in the city amid the ongoing deaths from opioids. Will your government continue to support those efforts that are already in place?
Well, I've always said, said it throughout the election and leadership, we are putting $1.9 billion into mental health, addiction, and housing support. My personal opinion is that we have to make sure that we get help for people, and I'm going to consult with doctors and professionals and get their input.
Safe injection sites, is that part of
that? Again, I'm going to get my advice from our medical teams, professionals in the industry. I think I've been clear on my stance about that. But again, hopefully we'll get matching money from the feds.
It's not part of the NAFTA negotiation, let me be clear.
But it's, again, we're going to put $1.9 billion. Hopefully the federal government will match that $1.9 billion. It'll be the largest investment, mental health, addiction, and housing that this country's ever seen, total of $3.8 billion. And again, I think it's absolutely critical. I call it an epidemic that we have to save lives. And the way, in my opinion, you save lives, first of all, you get the professional advice from the doctors and professionals, but you also need to give these people the support that they need.
Marika Walsh with iPolitics. This is for both of you. Many many industry groups and workers are feeling really anxious and squirrely about the tariffs that are already in place, but also the threats of auto tariffs. So, Mr. Ford, I'm wondering if you can shed any light on what confidence you have of whether this will or won't happen and what your message is for Ontario workers who would be affected. And Ms. Freeland, I'm wondering if your government would support some sort of support package for the auto and steel sectors.
Well, good question. I can reassure the people in the automotive industry and the steel and aluminum industry, we're going to work hard with our federal counterparts here. I have all the confidence in the world and the ambassador and the minister, the job they're doing. And let's see what happens here before we make any commitments. But we're going to have a strong voice, and I'm going to be working closely with the 19 governors down in the U.S., especially with the midterms coming up. I'll be working hard to get our message across. Again, we have a great relationship with the United States. We have a great business relationship, personal relationship, largest unprotected border in the world. The fight shouldn't be with Canada, in my opinion. We're going to continue on with that great relationship, and I know the federal government's working extremely hard around the clock to make sure we continue with that relationship. Minister.
Okay. Thank you very much for the question. So let me start with the steel and aluminum tariffs. As Canadians are well aware, those illegal Section 232 tariffs are already in force. They have come into effect not only with regards to Canada, but also the EU and Mexico. Canada has announced its retaliation list. We are currently in a consultation period, and that was one of the issues that we discussed in this meeting. That consultation period is important. It is giving stakeholders an opportunity to share with us views on what should and should not be on the list. It is giving provinces, as we just discussed today, an opportunity to share what should and should not be on the list. So that's an important process. We are working very, very energetically on that. And we have also been extremely clear, as I was today in my conversation with Ambassador Lighthizer, as we have been publicly clear many, many times, that on July 1st, Canada's retaliation list will come into effect. And I want to be clear with Canadians, this is a perfectly reciprocal, measured response. Also important, I think, for Canadians to appreciate that we are working in very close consultation with our allies. I speak to Cecilia Malmstrom, the EU Trade Commissioner, extremely regularly. I spoke to her again today. So we are doing this in concert with our allies. We've also raised cases both at the WTO and at NAFTA. And at the WTO, in addition to the Canadian case, the EU has raised a case, Mexico has raised a case, Japan has raised a case, Norway has raised a case, Thailand has raised a case. So this is now really the reality that the world is saying this action from the United States is illegal and unjustified, and we're making that case.
Okay, next question.
Justin Giovanetti from the Globe and Mail. Minister Freeland, can you tell us how close are you to bridging the auto parts, the auto section of NAFTA, which seems to be the main sticking point in talks right now?
That's a really good question. And we did talk both with the Premier Designate. We spoke a lot about autos and rules of origin. And I discussed that with Ambassador Lighthizer today. NAFTA is a trilateral deal. And when it comes to rules of origin, there are some important conversations that have to be had with Mexico. Those conversations are happening. I feel that we have made, over the past months, really since January, when Canada put forward some creative ideas, the U.S. responded to them in a productive way in March. And I think since then, we have made really significant progress on the rules of origin. It may sound to people like that's a long time, but this is very, very, very complicated. It is fiendishly complicated, as anyone in Ontario's auto industry will tell you. So I think good progress has been made to date. It's something I discussed with Ambassador Lighthizer, and we talked about a plan to work on and hopefully conclude that part of the negotiation.
Okay, next question.
Megan Fitzpatrick from CBC News. I have a two-part question for Mr. Ford and one question for Minister Freeland.
Wow. Three.
I got
three
in
one.
That's shot.
Pretty good.
Mr. Ford, you were talking about Ontario being open for business. Yesterday you were talking and you just outlined again some of the measures you intend to take to make Ontario more competitive. Mm-hmm. And that includes tax cuts, corporate tax cuts. Mm-hmm. And you campaigned on a message of relief is on its way. But in your platform, those tax cuts aren't set to come in until year two or three of your mandate. So I'm wondering why that is, if you're promising relief to the Ontario business community, why not do those tax cuts right away? And you were speaking a minute ago about reassuring workers in the auto industry and the steel industry and so on. Why weren't there any representatives of workers at the meeting yesterday? Why were those only industry representatives and no union representatives? And Minister Freeland, you were saying that this is useful to have Mr. Ford standing shoulder to shoulder, sign of solidarity, but beyond that, this meeting today and this show of support, are there any concrete actions you would like to see Mr. Ford take in terms of lobbying the American administration, officials? I mean, what advice do you have for him as he takes on this big challenge in just a few weeks?
Mr. Ford, why don't you start?
Okay, well, first of all, we'll be taking measures. We're already starting to take measures on reducing the burden onto companies and also the people of Ontario. We're going to reduce the gas tax by 10 cents per liter, which plays a role right across the board. We will be visiting the tax relief for small businesses of 8.75%, as well as the corporate tax of bringing it down from 11.5% down to 10.5%.
But that's only year
and
two, right?
Again, we will confirm that. It may change because we want to find out what are the real numbers, because we don't know the real numbers yet. When we get into office, we'll find out the real numbers. We'll have a minister of finance, I should say. We'll be going through the books. We're also bringing external auditors in to go line item by line item review to drive efficiencies. So the people and the businesses of Ontario will have tax relief. Again, we have 380,000 regulations here in Ontario. Given the direction to our secretary to start reviewing that. And I just want to mention Steve Orsini. He's an incredible person. I have a great deal of respect for him. And he's doing an incredible job so far. And we're going to make sure that we're competitive. We're going to be competitive around the world, because it's not about competing against the person down the street any longer, or even maybe another province. We're competing on a worldwide market right now, and we will be the most competitive market in the entire North America to do business in, as sure as I'm standing here.
The other part of my question, please, if you don't mind, sir, on the meeting yesterday, who was invited and who was not?
Well, we invited the industry leaders. I'm also going to be meeting with some union members. Matter of fact, I met with one of the heads of the union this morning. We didn't make a big deal about it, but I had a great meeting with him, and I'm going to meet with other union leaders, because this isn't about any longer about management versus union or liberal versus conservative. We're uniting as a country. We're going to stand together, no matter if you're union, non-union, management, liberal, NDP, conservative. We're going to stand together as a united country, and we're stronger together than we are apart. And the union understands that, and they know they have to be competitive, because if we aren't competitive, we aren't going to be in business. It's very simple, but we plan on being competitive. But thank you for the question.
So as for the premiers, let me just start by saying thank you to all of Canada's premiers. We have really been very effective as a country in playing as Team Canada in this very critical negotiation. And I am really grateful for all the work that premiers across the country have been doing in being part of the Team Canada effort. And as Premier Designate Ford has said, it really has been a non-partisan effort. We have approached this, I think all of us, as Canadians. Premier Mo of Saskatchewan was in Washington last week. I briefed him before he went, and he worked closely with our embassy there. And this is very effective, very important. So when it comes to Premier Designate Ford, one of the things we talked about was the role that premiers have been playing, all of the premiers in the country, in going out, talking directly to their counterparts in the United States, the governors. That's a very, very important job. Premier Designate Ford has already spoken about his understanding of the importance of that relationship between the province of Ontario and U.S. states, and having that human connection, going down there and making the case directly to the states. Governors have a very good understanding of the importance of trade for their states, and no one can make that case to a governor better than his or her direct counterpart, which is a provincial premier.
We'll be putting a full court press on the governors.
Last question.
In every state I can.
Hi, Rob Ferguson, Toronto Star. Is there, this is essentially an extension of the strategy Premier Wynne had. I'm just wondering, Mr. Ford, if you're bringing any new message to this. And Minister Freeland, if you think there's anything Ontario hasn't been doing in the past that it can, you know, add to the toolbox now.
Well, I'm going to say what I just said earlier. It's going to be a full court press. I'm going to be traveling to every single state, because nothing's better than meeting someone eye to eye. I can get on the phone, but nothing is better than visiting someone eye to eye. Had an opportunity to speak to Governor Snyder from Michigan. We've had a relationship. He's come up in the past to Toronto. We actually went to a Grey Cup game together a few years back, and so we have a good relationship. I'll have a good relationship with Governor Romney in Illinois, and who plays this key role is Governor Scott Walker. I've spent more time in Wisconsin than any other state, I think, including Illinois, and I'll be up there working hard with him and other governors around the U.S. Keep in mind, we're number one trading partner. I don't think the governors realize it, that their number one trading partner of 19 states is Ontario. We're number two to 9 other states. So that's 28 states that we can have face-to-face conversations and explain to them how critical it is that we carry on a great relationship with our closest partner, and that's the United States of America. And I'm proud to say that they're our neighbors. And like I said yesterday, obviously, number one is Canada in my heart and everyone else's, but I love the United States of America, and we can make a difference working with them.
Look, I think that the province of Ontario, like all the other provinces and territories of our country, frankly, like the cities of Canada, have been doing an outstanding job in playing for Team Canada, in taking the Canadian case directly to their American counterparts. That has been very important, and premiers across the country have been very effective, including Ontario. One of the things that we talked about was the way that Premier-designate Ford can do that work, and he's already spoken about, you know, his personal connections. Those obviously make a difference. I think the other thing we should all bear in mind is now with the Section 232 U.S. tariffs having come into place, with the Canadian retaliation list now published, being fine-tuned during our consultation period, we're entering a new phase. And this is a really important phase because this is a moment when, as all of us go and speak to our U.S. counterparts, we're able to say, this is really a bad idea. And, you know, as I said in Washington yesterday, this is an opportunity when we need to be making the case that having this kind of dispute hurts American consumers, hurts American businesses as well. And I think that is going to be a message that all of us are going to be taking to our American counterparts, because as the Premier Designate said, we have a great trading relationship with the United States. The Premier has spoken about Ontario. Let me speak about Canada. Canada is the single largest market for the United States, larger than China, Japan, and the UK combined. They're important to us. We are also really important to them. And I think that is an argument that all Canadians at all levels have been making, and I think we now need to make with even greater renewed vigor. And one of the things that gives us an edge in making this argument is the fact that when it comes to this particular issue, our country is absolutely united. And that's why I want to thank Premier-elect Doug Ford, designate Doug Ford, for the opportunity to talk with him about this important issue and to show Canadians and Americans that Canadians stand together.
Thank you. Thank you very much, everybody. Thank you.